Beards. You have them, he has them, she has them, I sort of have one. But now that everyone has a beard, evolution says that beards are so over. Howdy folks, thanks for tuning in to D News, I'm Trace. Studies have shown beards equate to age, masculinity, and dominance, and they are so hot right now, or are they? A new study in the Royal Society Journal Biology Letters will affect men from Brooklyn to San Francisco, from Portland to Austin. The more beards there are, the less attractive beards are. The study in Biology Letters found that once the number of beards peak, clean-shaven faces become more attractive to the ladies. The study showed women pictures of men with and without facial hair, and when a clean-shaven man was shown amongst lots of stubbly and beardy peeps, their freshly shorn skin was aglow with attractiveness. Conversely, in a sea of baby faces, the bearded man was king. Are the ladies picky, or is there something else at work? The researchers determined a famous bearded gent was to blame. Darwin's theories of evolutionary sexual selection says females choose those males with the most desirable features. So physique, intelligence, or whatever. But they're not sure how they decide. Obviously, we want the best genes to perpetuate and the crap ones left out, but how do people know which are the good genes? Scarcity, my friends. This study finally revealed a long-time evolutionary problem. Those who roll outside the mainstream, who are rare or unique, are thought to have a genetic edge. For example, people with blonde hair in populations of brunettes, fatter people in skinny populations, tall people amongst shorties, vice versa, and so on. Scarcity equates to attractiveness. The researchers used the example of guppies, which is such a good hipster comparison. In guppies, the fish with the most unusual color patterns have the most mating success. Do they have the best genes? Maybe. The ladyfish don't know, but they are different, and different is cool. You could also think of the closing time effect. A study in the journal Basic and Applied Social Psychology found that at the end of a night out, people take stock of their patrons and assess attractiveness based on who's like left at the bar. We determine attractiveness by who's around, not just by genes and uniqueness alone. Remember that week-long high school trip to Seattle where you bunked in with Jesse because Jesse was the hottest one on the bus? What happened when you got back home? Bye-bye, Jesse, because there are other hotties around. So to bring it back to beards, we are hitting a, quote, beard peak, where the novelty of a man with facial hair has lost its unusual quality. However, it's important to mention that there are different levels of beardiness. The researchers in Biology Letters used four distinct levels: clean-shaven, light stubble, heavy stubble, and full beard. I think they're missing, of course, the past full beard, ludicrous beard, but maybe that's just me. A lumberjack of Brooklyn would be unique to the bushier Portland, and thus perhaps scarce, and thus hot. Overall though, a lot of news is claiming that those men who shave are going to get the attention for now. So the beard struggle is real, y'all. Are beards over? What do you think? Tell us down below, but if you decide you're gonna shave, it might be time to check out Harry's. Harry's was started by two guys who thought paying a crap ton for crap blades was a horrible experience. They bought a German razor factory and made the experience of getting your razors cheaper and classier. I love the packaging and the blades are affordable and actually pretty sweet. If you want to go and try them and support the show, go to harrys.com and use the promo code DNEWS to save $5 off your first purchase. You can order them right online and ship them to your door and be shaven 5 minutes later. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.